There are prescription drugs for almost everything these days. Vitamins and hormones and medicines and inhibitors and killers and boosters. You guys, this kind of sounds like a bunch of gangs. Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to DNews today. I'm Trace. A drug is a compound molecule or group of molecules that affects your physiology once it's ingested. One of the best-selling prescription drugs in the United States is adalimumab, prescribed for inflammatory diseases like arthritis or Crohn's. The thing is, 306 other medications interact with adalimumab, including 940 brand and generic drugs. Some, like the vaccines for polio and smallpox and MMR, interact so seriously that the risks outweigh the benefits. No doctor could know all 1,000 interactions, and that's just with one drug. According to the FDA, almost half of the US population has used a prescription drug in the last 30 days. 22% of us have used three drugs in that time, and nearly 11% have used five or more. Doctors need to keep a watchful eye on what medications each of us are taking, because sometimes when drugs mix inside of our bodies, the results are dangerous or deadly. According to the National Institutes of Health, DDIs, or drug-drug interactions, occur when two drugs interact with the same product. So if two drugs attempt to alter the same specific hormone or gene or molecular pathway, for example, their attempts to fix the problem could become a bigger issue than the problem itself. According to a paper from Stanford, DDIs result from the drug working too slowly or too quickly. So either the enzyme responsible for metabolizing drug B is inhibited by drug A, causing an increased concentration in the body, or drug A kicks up the production of a metabolizing enzyme, diluting drug B in the body. Both are bad, because then the drug's not doing its job. Potentially worse, though, is that the two drugs interact in a way that produces an effect that neither would on their own. Drug-drug interactions are often discovered in the testing of these compounds, and the understanding of what pathways, enzymes, and genes will be affected by and affect any drug. Though, a new computer algorithm from Stanford data mines the millions of reports filed with the US Food and Drug Administration to reveal as yet unknown side effects in DDIs by digging through all these medical reports and available patient histories. DDIs are actually really common, and often people simply ignore or forget that something in their life is actually a drug. For example, a simple antihistamine, which would normally reduce runny noses, sneezing, or allergic reactions, negatively interacts with alcohol, sedatives, high blood pressure medications, antidepressants, and a bunch of others. In fact, many people forget that caffeine, alcohol, and nicotine are even drugs at all, and thus have their own DDIs. When mixed with alcohol, for example, the over-the-counter drug known as acetaminophen, branded as Tylenol, can cause serious liver damage. Thinking back to the different types of DDIs, both alcohol and acetaminophen are metabolized by the liver. Alcohol causes acetaminophen to break down more quickly, creating a toxic and damaging byproduct, N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone, or NAPQI. Normally, the liver has a binding agent called glutathione, which saves it, but not under DDI conditions. That can cause acute liver failure and the need of an immediate transplant. That's serious stuff, and it's just acetaminophen and alcohol. And that's one DDI. When mixed with some prescription medications, alcohol can cause internal bleeding, heart damage, and far more serious problems. Another thing people forget to consider is birth control. Birth control is a prescription medication, one that many forget to divulge because it becomes such a routine part of their lives. Even more so for women who are on the ring or the patch or other long-term methods. A 1990 study in clinical pharmacokinetics found no strict evidence that oral contraceptives can be affected by most drugs, but Planned Parenthood and physicians will recommend caution when taking oral contraception and a specific anti-tuberculosis drug. However, some analgesics, like acetaminophen mentioned earlier, may be less effective when people are on the pill, while some antidepressants and tranquilizers, their effects might be exaggerated. In the end, not everyone will have the same DDI with the same dosage, which is why it's important to read the drug labels and be conscious of the drugs you're taking. On top of that, be open and honest with your doctor. If you're curious, you can always look it up on drugs.com. It's run by some pharmacists out of New Zealand who wanted to make DDIs more transparent. It's actually pretty fascinating. As we get older, we do tend to take more drugs. A report from Harvard states that Americans over 70 can take as many as seven. So when it comes to DDIs, obviously, more research is definitely needed. Do you know when your medicines even expire, though? Because that's kind of important when it comes to DDIs. Why don't you check out this video here and get the rundown.
Typically, the expiration date is set a year to 5 years beyond the date of manufacture. It's less of an expiration date and more of a date of guaranteed potency. Basically, after that date, manufacturers can't guarantee the drug will be 100% potent.
Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Please subscribe so you get more videos every single day of the week, and let us know down in the comments if you ever even thought about these interactions, or if you learned about one that kind of blew your mind. Thanks for watching.